Sisense has a number of tools that make it quick and easy to work with tables in your data model. Over here, you can see we've got a few tables we can work with, and we're going to discuss some of the basic and advanced configuration options available. First off, when I hover over a table, a hint pops up that shows me where the data source is, the type of data source, its location, the number of columns, and the original table name. If I click on this table, a set of icons appears. From here, I can delete the table or rename it. To rename the table, I simply give it another name. The semantic layer, the layer that enables you to name tables and fields, is open to you. It doesn't actually impact the original data, so feel free to rename tables and fields to whatever makes the most sense to you. If the table's already been built, that is, we've done a build and imported the data already, I can click on the icon to preview the table data. Again, this is only available after a build. Looking at the advanced menu options for tables, we have the options to determine whether the table should be visible. What this means is when somebody is developing a dashboard, we might not want to show them the table. Sometimes we might want to use the table for data preparation or for other purposes. So here we can actually hide the table by checking the hide option. Here we can also duplicate the table or to add a custom field to the table. Custom fields are something we're going to discuss in a later video. In addition, we can add descriptions and tags to our table. What this does is it enables us to define metadata and provides the basis for a data dictionary without affecting the original data. After you've tagged your data, you can easily locate the tagged tables in the search field by entering the pound sign. This then displays a list of all the tags that you can select to filter your data. Additionally, this menu has two additional categories of settings that we can choose from. The first one is connection settings that we can use to update our settings when our data sources change. Check out the video Changing Connectivity Settings for more information. The other set of settings is the build behavior. This determines how the data should be imported into the table and when. These build settings are something we'll also go into in a later video. Until now, we've been discussing how you can work with tables. In addition to that, there are a few features to work with fields. So over here, we redefine the relationship between the tables. We can rename and duplicate a field. We can determine to hide a field from the end user, so if we've built a cube, we might not want to show some fields to the dashboard developers. So over here, we can hide them. Here we can even remove a field altogether from the table, without affecting the original data. In addition, clicking on this field allows you to index the column data for quicker processing and subsequent builds. This option is available for only text fields. Here I can select the type of data contained within the field, so I can change it from various numeric field options to date, time, or to text. Obviously, the data has to support this type of field change. Those are the two sets of options that make it really easy to change data names, to work with tables, to manage certain settings within tables. In addition, because it's a visual environment, we can always move things around to determine where a table should be placed to get a more logical layout if needed. So these are our options, and they really make it quick and easy to work with tables and fields within data models. For more information, see our online documentation.